570 clear, Hag 48 has the mark.
Yes.
Let's try him again.
Okay, here comes the flanger.
Try taking him up and down again.
Yeah, I think I need to get some more air pressure built back up in here. I think we found the proper way to operate it. 11 came up here and took a look, and that's probably why you dropped the air pressure. We're building the reservoirs up more. I had to change some valves around here, so it's going to take a little bit.
All right, copy that. We also let quite a bit of air off. We're trying to harvest down while we're hammering it.
No horn. The pressure's building up though. So this valve handle right here is for the left wing in the direction of travel up in the Russell Snow Plow. Right now the handle is on the inward or retracted position because it's coming into the center of the plow. So that means the wing is also retracted. If I were to pull up on this safety handle and then push it out to the stop over here, then the wing, the left wing would go out to its full extent, and then I could bring it back in. This down here is a cutout cock for the left wing. This is your air gauge up here in the plow. Over here you have the controls for the flanger, and it's the same idea. You have a cutout cock or a cutout valve here for the flanger control. And then right here, this is the operating valve for the flanger itself, which operates in the same way as the wing valve handle. 34 copies. Yep, flanger's coming down. Bobby, we seem to drop a lot of air pressure though using these controls. Weird, and if you leave them over, it still draws the air pressure down.
It doesn't make any sense. If they're out, they should be out. That's
yeah.
Right. They shouldn't need the air pressure to stay out.
That's right, yeah.
5-3, good for 4 around the curve.
cars and whip them out. And we're at the whistle post.